Get your ducks in a row, a straight row with no gaps. An all-new AFE Animal Edition starts right now. Give us something to dance to, and something a bear might like to jam out to. That's right, sounds good. Now jack up that audio. Let's get that bear up on his feet. I'm thinking he might want to book you for their next den party. Bears do love a funky beat, second only to honey. And you know, mauling DJs.
Oh my God, honey, bear!
Welcome to America's Funniest Home Videos, Animal Edition. And now, when he cries wolf, a pack of wolves actually show up at his door. Alfonso Ribeiro.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the show. All creatures have different ways of showing enjoyment. Cats purr, dogs wag their tail, some monkeys howl, horses neigh, birds chirp, and we laugh. And we, I have a cousin who actually snorts when he laughs, and I mean snorts, like I'll be honest, when we watch funny animal videos, we make him go watch in another room. Oh, yeah, we still hear him. It's just not as loud.
He had the whole beach to choose from, but he had to dig right there. And that's why she always wears a hat. A lesser bear would spend hours meticulously going through the trash to find the perfect morsel of goodness. But Boo Boo don't play that. Boo Boo's way is much, much faster. Now you can see what you're dealing with.
Yeah.
Water. H2O. Hydration. Garden hose tears. Shower. Moisture. Drinking. Agua fria. The key is to know when to let go. Because if you hold on for too long, this can happen.
Daisy May, what did you do?
I'm guessing she scared the heck out of the hamster.
Are you checking to see if the hamster was still in there?
I'm guessing the hamster is either hiding under the sofa or is in Daisy May's tummy.
Really?
I actually think Daisy May just wants to be the first pug astronaut.
Daisy.
A pugstronaut. You can lead a horse to water, but you should always bring a towel. Marty was understandably nervous because it was his first funeral. And when it was showtime, Marty just froze. Stage fright affects everyone differently.
Let me assure you that no matter how bad your day is going, there is always someone somewhere that is having it 100 times worse and would give anything to switch places with you. For instance, I bet we're all glad we're not this guy.
Every expert beekeeper was once a rank amateur, just like this guy. He bought the mask and the smoke canister, but figured he didn't really need the protective beekeeper suit. That was mostly for show, right? You know, as long as he had long sleeves. He didn't even really know how to get the honey out. There must be some sort of latch or something. I think that rooster is trying to say, you're doing it wrong. So I guess you just lift, right? And here we go. Oh, he's not good at this.
The camera.
So seriously, no matter what's going on in your life, aren't you glad you're not that guy?
Ever wish your pet could talk just so they could explain themselves? I would love it if a cat would tell me why they feel the urge to run into another room as fast as they can for no apparent reason. And wouldn't it be great if your dog could explain why, when you get out of the shower, he just stares at you and then just tilts his head with that puzzled expression on his face? These are the things I need answers to. So come on, animals. We're listening.
Do you wanna go somewhere? Like maybe downstairs? Do you wanna have a cookie? Do you want a cookie?
I want a cookie.
Do you? I love you.
The only thing preventing her from becoming the neighborhood's crazy cat lady is that cats...
What are you doing up there?
...don't really like her.
Ow!
How you doing? You want to talk to me? Hi. Come on, say something.
This is what happens when you don't call your parents.
The nasty old crows are back. I know.
They end up talking to ravens.
Hey.
And having full conversations.
Yes. Yes. Whoa.
So what do you say you call your folks after the show?
Ooh. Oh, you're so funny. You are. Yes, you are.
They miss you.
Oh, no.
Hey, Cal. Go home.
Maybe if you use the loudspeaker.
Go home. Now. Good job.
Do you guys remember taking two soup cans and a string and making a telephone with your friend?
I do.
I've made the same kind of thing with solo cups, some metal foil, and a speaker cone spring. But when I put this thing up against my beehive...
Bees rule, wasps drool!
Have y'all ever heard of anything like this before?
When you live out on a farm by yourself...
What?
Friendship is hard to come by.
What?
As is stimulating conversation.
What?
So you end up... talking to whoever will listen.
I know.
Most animals are natural-born athletes. They have to be, you know, to survive. And some of our all-time greatest athletes have animal names. Larry Bird, Tony Hawk, Tiger Woods, Catfish Hunter, just to name a few. But more than the name is the skill set. Only the best athletes can be a member of Alfonso's Animal All-Stars.
The goal is up here. And... you'll believe a dog can fly. Puppies may get to play the Super Bowl halftime, but this guy earned his all-star entry by running the pigskin down the field every Thanksgiving. This is a gravy bowl he doesn't mind being a part of. You can bend it like Beckham, mash it like Maradona, punt it like Pele, and rip it like Ronaldo. But if you want to make Alfonso's Animal All-Stars, you need to learn to whip it like Whiskers. Because there's Whiskers, and then there's everybody else.
Sometimes it's the rustling of leaves or a sudden movement you glimpse from the corner of your eye. Other times, it's the feeling of a big sloppy tongue squishing between the toes of your bare feet while you're trying to catch a nap on the sofa. Yeah, that one gives me the heebie-jeebies. But they all mean you are about to have a close encounter of the animal kind.
Jasper loved finding a secluded bank where he could kick back, fish a little, and be alone with his thoughts. Of course, even when you think you are alone, you might not be. Time to find a new spot.
Wow. Wow, wow, wow.
Hello, little squirrel.
And then he uttered those famous last words.
No, he's not. He's not gonna bite me.
Ow!
Some of the elk in Evergreen, Colorado are just mad at the world. Might be hard to explain that to your insurance agent.
Don't you hate it when you're on your way somewhere important and then out of nowhere your path is blocked and you have to turn around and find an alternate route and you're like, but the ice cream shop closes in 10 minutes. The struggle is real, people.
Not only was it his favorite mountain bike path, but it was also the quickest way to get home. You know, unless there was traffic.
Hey. All right.
But what do you think caused him to turn around? Is it A, a mountain lion? B, the girl he met at a party and then ghosted even though he promised he would call? C, a bear? Or D, a pack of wolves? Think about it, and I will tell you the answer when AFV Animal Edition returns.
Breakneck speed through the woods is one of life's simplest and best pleasures. That is, until things get complicated. Okay, he's doing good, keeping his cool. Whatever he sees, he knows it's a potentially dangerous situation. That's good. Keep your eyes on it. Maybe it'll go away. Then again, maybe it won't. That's what you do with a black bear. Make yourself big and make a little noise. Bet he takes a different path next time.
All right, make sure you pay attention to each and every video because at the end of the show, we are going to award $1,000 to the clip we enjoyed the most. So keep track and let's see if your pick matches ours. Yeah. The dream is always the same. I had it again last night. In it, I'm wearing this chicken suit, yellow feathers, a giant beak, and I'm strutting around. So I'm strutting around in my chicken suit, and this giant farmer is tossing seed on the ground, and he says, I'm expecting more eggs from you, Alfonso. And so I say, looks like it's time for another edition of What's That Dog Barking At Now?
Oh, he sees something, and it has his engine all revved up. Is it the Loch Ness Monster? A whale? A mermaid? What is it, boy? What do you see? In the sea, what is it? Dolphins! Lots and lots of dolphins. And let's be honest, they are sort of freaking him out.
There is nothing I love more than a really good animal documentary. I'm always amazed at the footage they're able to capture. It's like some of those animals were meant to be movie stars, but not all animals are cut out to be featured on film. So tonight, we are counting down the top 10 animals that don't want to be in your nature documentary. Let's begin with the bottom five.
Number 10. Oh, they may seem all cute and cuddly, but a lot of squirrels aren't comfortable being recorded and would prefer not to be. Number 9. When the camera comes out,
Astro
is suddenly nowhere to be found.
Are you stuck under there? Hey!
There he is. Okay, Astro, time to sparkle.
Come on! You silly dog.
Number 8. Some octopus documentaries win awards. This octopus is going to take the camera and then the cameraman. Number 7. Here he comes.
Here he comes.
Number 6. That whole frog turning into a prince thing never really works out like you think it's going to.
You are adorable. Can I keep it?
No.
We will continue our countdown a little later in the show.
Are you okay?
Okay, here's my favorite animal joke of all time. Make sure you share it with your friends. All right, so a policeman sees a car drive by with 20 penguins in the back seat. He pulls the car over and tells the driver to immediately take those penguins to the zoo. A week later, the policeman sees the same car. In the back seat are the same 20 penguins, but now they are wearing sunglasses. The policeman pulls the driver over and says, hey, buddy, I thought I told you to take those penguins to the zoo. And the driver says, I did. And we had such a great time that today I'm taking them to the beach. I bet other animals would go to the zoo too if they had a chance, as you will see in Will and Jed's Excellent Adventure.
Will and Jed always dreamed of taking a trip into town and seeing the sights. And they wanted to go by rail. So they bought a ticket and waited and waited and waited. Horses can't tell time. It's why you never see one wearing a watch. The train finally arrived. All aboard! Having never been on a train before, they weren't exactly sure where they were supposed to go. So they ended up in baggage. Let the adventure begin. Hey, this suitcase is blocking their view. Much better. If the other animals back at the stable could see them now. They were able to check riding a train off their feed bucket list. Next item, they wanted to go to the zoo. And they were greeted like family. Will and Jed saw otters, llamas, goats, and owls. Then it was time for a nature walk and some rock climbing. Just look at that view. Sort of took their breath away. Oop, time to be getting back. They couldn't wait to tell their friends at the farm about their adventure. It's times like these they wish they could tell time. Don't want to miss the train back. Will and Jed truly had an excellent adventure. Next week, the beach.
There are certain facts in life that you can just count on. Like, you know the sun is going to come up in the morning. You know that after Thanksgiving, your uncle is going to lay on the couch, unbutton the top button on his pants, and moan, "Why did you let me eat so much?" And you know cats hate water. All true, except maybe that last one. I even have proof.
Now, almost every credible veterinarian and scientist will tell you this will not make your kitty cat grow faster.
We are watering our cat.
But they also agree it won't make them shrink either. So, if the cat likes it, there isn't any harm.
You feel better?
Go get it, Spike.
Spike loves watering day. Chasing the water stream is better than chasing mice for him. When it rains, Spike loses his mind. Man, that is some good stuff right there. Refreshing. Snowball spends most of every day playing with the slide water. She fights it, smacks it, dabs at it, lets it flow through her paws. But every now and again, she gets a little carried away. Literally. I wonder how Snowball feels about the blow dryer.
And now it's time for the Animal News Network. We get all our information straight from the horse's mouth.
I'm Alfonso Ribeiro, and here now, the Animal News. It's official. Cement mason and concrete finisher Rafael Ladrillo has retired.
After a 37-year career pouring and smoothing cement in the tri-state area, Ladrillo was considered the best there ever was. Each backyard that needed a patio or deck was his canvas, and his trowel was his paintbrush. When asked why he was retiring, Ladrillo, who was often called the Michelangelo of cement, said, "It's those dogs, man." Ladrillo plans to move to the Samoan islands of Manono because it is the one place he knows of where dogs of any kind have been banned. Ah, how smooth their cement must be.
The migration of the humpback whales continues off the coast of California.
And some sightseers have been able to witness it firsthand. We at ANN would like to remind you that you should never get too close to a whale if you can help it.
Oh!
Everyone was okay and spent the rest of their day on shore.
And in environmental news, a new company is using the power of canine mandibles to trim trees along our highways and byways.
Barking Up the Wrong Tree Incorporated has deployed dozens of tree-chewing canines to trim overhanging branches so motorists can pass with ease. Says a spokesman for the company, it's like playing fetch right from the source.
And now it's time for an Animal News Network fake fact.
When an octopus runs out of ink, it can refill with any compatible ink cartridge from the office supply store.
No!
that true? I'm Alfonso Ribeiro, wishing you the happiest of animal news. And now, quite possibly the coolest thing you will see today. Beautiful, isn't it? I know it doesn't look real, but let me assure you, it is. It is a sea angel, a small swimming sea slug. Looks like something Pixar would create, but nature did. And it is quite possibly the coolest thing you will see today.
All right, let me ask you a personal question. How well do you know your pinnipeds? Now, don't be embarrassed. I think we've all mixed up a seal with a sea lion before. Seriously, how do you tell them apart? Well, I'm glad you asked, because after this, you will definitely know the difference.
Seals and sea lions have an awful lot in common. They both swim, sunbathe, and they're both pinnipeds, which means they're fin-footed. Basically the same, right? Of course not. There are some major differences between the two. Sea lions get around pretty easily by lifting their bodies up with their flippers. How graceful. Seals, on the other hand, have to scooch around on their bellies. Not graceful and exhausting. But seal flippers do have long claws to help them get around and scratch those hard-to-reach places. Oh. Another difference is the ear holes. You heard me, ear holes. Seals have ear holes on either side of their head that give them a well-developed sense of hearing. Sea lions also have ear holes, but they come with little ear flaps. Kind of cute, isn't it? Sea lions are loud. Very loud. They bark to communicate. And they communicate a lot. Even underwater. Seals, however, are much quieter creatures. They're more chill. They vocalize through grunts that sound like this. Well, excuse you. One thing seals and sea lions do share, the same major predators. Sharks and orcas. Yeah, probably a good time to get out of the water, fellas. So from now on, you will be able to identify who is a seal and who is a sea lion. Because now, you know the difference.
Some of my favorite memories involve those carefree times at the playground. Me running up the slide, trying to swing as high as I could, and then leaping out of the swing and soaring across the blacktop. And all that was just last week. Man, I can't wait to make more memories this weekend.
Steven Slack! Yeah, buddy!
Let's do some animal math. Get your pencil and paper ready. You got it? Okay, we're going to do some AFE animal addition. So take the number of eyes a bee has and add that to the number of stomachs a cow has, and then add the number of hearts an octopus has. Think you have it? Check your work, and I will give you the answer when AFE Animal Edition returns. Let's get our animal math on. If you take the number of eyes on a bee, which is 5, and add that to the number of stomachs a cow has, which is 4, and then add the number of hearts an octopus has, which is 3, we end up with 5 + 4 + 3 = 12. Now, you know what? If that question was on the SAT, it would be so much more fun to take. Now, listen, I do love Great Danes, but I am not sure I have a favorite. You got Marmaduke, Scooby-Doo, Astro from the Jetsons, and, of course, Hamlet. What? Hamlet was a Great Dane? He was the Prince of Denmark, for crying out loud. Still, he was no Scooby-Doo. I see you. I see you again. They literally do this for hours. There he is. Never gets old. They have won the Great Dane Peekaboo competition 6 years in a row.
He's crazy. Are you crazy?
Crazy for peekaboo. Oh, they bought him bigger beds as he grew, but nothing could replace the one he had as a puppy. See, he fits. Sort of. The best thing about having a black and white kitty and a black and white doggy is that they go with anything. The kitty is wondering where the ball of yarn is. Fact of the matter, it's in Goliath's tummy. He ate it. The best thing about having a buddy that is so jowly is all the food that gets stuck up in there. It's like a full meal. Hey, is that a chicken nugget in there? Yes. Yes, it is.
Oh, Rufus.
If I say ow, you're really? On skin.
Here's the deal. It's his chair.
Sit down.
Maybe there's room for both of you.
He says if you won't give my chair back, I'm taking it back.
Rufus.
They should seriously consider getting a sofa. Okay, Rufus, enough messing around. Go ahead and sit down.
Sit down, Roo.
Sit down. Roo.
Rufus.
Well, that can't be pleasant.
Rufus.
Heck, I'd have given him the chair.
Too bad.
Here comes Trouble. I wonder why they named him Trouble. Our countdown on the top 10 animals that don't want to be in your nature documentary continues with number 5. Ah, the elusive octopus. This footage is going to be amazing. Unless, of course, he decided to start changing colors and then just blend in with the coral. Number 4. The itsy bitsy spider climbed up the rooftop. Saw you with the camera and decided to make it stop. Number 3.
What are you doing, Mr. Muskrat?
He's feeling he really doesn't want to be on camera. Number 2. Oh, he sees the camera and he knows he looks good. He's just not having it. We'll continue our countdown with number 1 a little later in the show. I have a riddle for you. Do you know what makes twice as much noise as a barking dog? 2 barking dogs. You can do that one on your friends. 2. Let's reach back into the treasure trove that is the AFE Animal Archive.
Who tore the blinds down?
I wonder.
Not Hank. Who was it, Hank? Oh, Stella, did you do it? Sure looks like you did it. Can you look at me? Stella, can you look at me?
Gonna be hard to talk her way out of this one. He didn't do many impressions, but the whole flock agreed that his weather vane was spot on. Marley couldn't help but feel the parrot was mocking him somehow.
Oh,
are scratching so hard, it smells like bacon cooking. And stay there. When you see something you want, it only takes one moment of pure courage to get it. Roll over.
There he goes.
Good dog.
Look at all the puppies.
Ooh. A puppet show.
These were the kids' favorite when they rode to school with Dad way back when they were... Hey, wait a minute. That's not a puppet. That's the bulldog.
So, what? No puppet show?
Animals and people alike have fears. It is a safety mechanism that, frankly, keeps us from getting hurt. But sometimes a fear is so intense that it is actually given a very long, complicated, and hard-to-pronounce name. So it's time to know your phobia. Today's irrational animal fear is ostraconophobia. So is ostraconophobia the fear of A, ostriches, B, shellfish, C, Labrador retrievers, or D, burrows? Think you know? Well, I will tell you the answer when AFE Animal Edition returns.
That was scary, Master.
Fun fact, ostraconophobia is the irrational fear of lobsters. And crabs, and all shellfish. Ostraconophobia is extremely rare, but for those who suffer from it, it doesn't make it any less real. By the way, I've heard the fear of butter is bautironophobia. So you never want to take a bautironophobic and an ostraconophobic to a seafood restaurant. It will not be pleasant for anyone.
My inbox is bombarded with scams, warranty extension deals, pizza coupons, vacation offers, and things that don't relate to me at all. That is why I love hearing from you and our AFV Animal Edition inbox. These emails I enjoy getting. Our first one is from Ricardo from Ottumwa, Iowa. He writes, Dear Alfonso, do you ever feel sorry for cows? I mean, their lives seem so boring sometimes. They just stand around and chew. What gives? Oh, Ricardo. That may have been true in the past, but today's cow has more opportunities than ever before. In fact, I know two cows who've begun an exciting career as building inspectors.
Contractors who want to make sure their new houses are built to industry standards can do no better than hiring Bessie and Gern to perform an on-site inspection. They're sticklers for detail and will make sure everything is up to code before you move in.
Annette from Leavenworth, Kansas asks, Hey, Alfonso, how come you don't see more young girl stable hands? Great question, Annette. First, there are those pesky child labor laws. And second, there are some jobs that require a little more strength than a little girl may have.
Little girls make great riders, and they can groom a little horse for hours, it seems. But when it comes to some tasks...
Got her?
Hey.
The horse uses its size against them.
Uh-oh, she's getting out. You gotta get her back in.
Okay.
In just a few years, if she eats all her vegetables, she'll be able to handle any horse like a veteran stable hand.
What do you tell her?
Yeah.
But until that day comes...
Dear Alfonso, where do emus take their families on vacation? Just curious, Jenna. Well, Jenna, that's easy. Just like us, emus like to go to the beach.
We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 chicks.
Wow, 18. Looks like Dad brought the whole family and a couple of cousins. Let's see, there's Emmy, Aaron, Cookie, Sprout, Boomer, Puddin', Luna, Rufus, Coco, Ernie, Donkers, Poofy, Eddie, Tam, Pebbles, Taj, Olive, and Bean. Geez, so many beaks to feed. But that isn't a problem at the beach. You just head over to the hotel and enjoy some outdoor buffet.
They're so cute.
Let's do one more. Dear Alfonso, do you have a favorite butterfly? Your pal, Dwight, Lexington, Kentucky. Great question, Dwight. And yes, yes I do. I like all butterflies, but my absolute favorite is number 88.
47 was my favorite for a long time. And I think we all go through our 57 phase. But ever since I laid my eyes on good old 88 here, well, I have a new favorite. I just like the way he moves. He's sort of a dancer. You go, 88.
I do love getting mail, so keep sending them in and I will answer as many of them as I can. I love this job because it's like a happy family around here. And I want you to get to meet the pets of the hardworking people that make all this happen and our AFE Animal Edition staff members' pet of the day.
Hey, I'm Melissa. This is Bane. And this is Miko. Their favorite thing is to do is to run and chase each other and play in the park. So say hi to Alfonso, Bane. Miko, say hi to Alfonso.
Aren't they adorable? I am so glad Melissa, Bane, and Miko are part of the AFV Animal Edition family. So do you have a favorite clip yet? Because at the end of the show, we will choose one video to receive $1,000. I want to see if we pick the same one. We will also share our viral clip of the week and conclude our top 10 list. All this and quite a bit more when AFE Animal Edition continues.
Who is this guy? Ever heard of personal space? Back off, pal.
Personally, I love every animal video I have ever seen. But every now and again, someone captures something so incredible that in a very short time, it is seen around the world by millions of people. And so is the case with our viral clip of the week.
When you see a cute little baby cougar on a path, mommy can't be too far behind. And so it began. It must have felt like an eternity. But the mother cougar backed the hiker down the trail for 6 minutes.
No! What's up, dude?
I would have been concerned the cougar was just working up an appetite.
You're a good little kitty cat.
Somehow, Kyle kept his cool.
Nice and slow.
Made noises. Retreated while making himself big.
I'm being scary.
And somehow was able to film the entire thing.
Go away. Go get your babies.
Almost 8 million people have viewed the entire video online, and should you desire, I suggest checking it out.
No!
All 6 minutes are just as intense as what I'm showing you now.
My heart is racing. I just wanted to go on a run. Nope. Stupid kitty cat.
And after the cougar felt a point had been made, she turned around and went back to her cubs, leaving a very relieved Kyle.
Yeah, so that just happened. Wow. You see that? Oh, some will come, actually. Holy cow.
Holy cow, indeed.
Yeah, not going back that way.
Good call.
A lot of people believe a house is not a home unless at least one animal lives there, too. In fact, 70% of U.S. homes have at least one. But 100% of homes believe that some animals don't belong in the house.
We've got a bird in our house. Let's get Dana.
And here we go. I bet Dallas Donuts that nosy neighbor Mrs. Higgins just called the police to report a ruckus. And Mrs. Higgins will not tolerate a ruckus. A lynx should never be in the house for the obvious reasons. And also, they hate ceiling fans. One way to get an unwanted critter out of the house is to simply offer them a ride on a broom.
Anybody want to go for a ride? Okay, hold on.
And then head for the great outdoors.
Hold on.
You might want to latch the screen door this time, or he's just going to come right back in.
I need to warn some of our more sensitive viewers right now that what you are about to see is pretty intense. So listen, take a deep breath, center yourself, muster some courage, and prepare for when super cute puppies attack.
Oh, he's a fierce one. That dandelion had better watch its step. Next, he's gonna mangle a tulip. Getting caught shredding paper didn't faze him at all. In fact, it empowered him. He attacked his dental hygiene with a vengeance. He was the best flosser of the entire litter. It wasn't the foot that was making him angry, but that sock could be smelled from three counties away. It had to be stopped. It's so true. Sometimes the cutest faces are the ones you have to be the most careful of.
We have been counting down the top 10 animals that don't want to be in your nature documentary. But before reveal number one, let's take a look at the first nine.
Number 10, camera-shy squirrel. Number 9, lost in the leaves. Number 8, the tentacle tackle. Number 7, emergency landing. Number 6,
can I keep it?
Finders keepers. Number 5, just trying to blend in. Number 4, 8 legs of steel. Number 3, muskrat love. Number 2, doggy tonsils.
And now on our countdown of the top 10 animals that don't want to be in your nature documentary, we give you number 1.
No one had ever photographed Big Shelly before. So when she came into view, it was very exciting. Uh-oh. Well, at least they got some footage. Oh, no, she's eating it. Ew. That was kind of gross. That was also number 1.
I know you had a lot to choose from, but did you pick a favorite? It's always a difficult decision, but the video we enjoyed the most and the recipient of $1,000 is Paw Prints in Cement, submitted by Sue Bosley from Katy, Texas.
Maybe you can use some of that to redo the back deck, Sue.
It is so true. Time really does fly when you're having fun. And in addition to having a great time, I would go so far as to say we learned a little something as well. We learned that bears love techno as much as they love honey.
We learned that elk antlers are tougher than car doors. That'll buff right out. We learned that not all birds can soar like the eagle. That dogs love water. Ponies love to catch the morning train. And bees may be secretly planning something.
Let's sting Alfonso!
But most of all, we learned that any time we can be laughing, playing, and hanging out with our animal friends is time well spent. Let's do this again real soon.